Alright guys, and welcome to the first episode of the new series of videos that I'm going to be doing on my channel. So, I haven't yet decided what I'm going to be naming these videos, but there's probably going to be three types. There's going to be terraforming, there's going to be let's builds, and there's going to be tutorials. Now, up on my wall, which I can't really show you right now, although I might take a picture and put it into the video, but I'll talk over it anyway. As if you can't see, I've got 8 pieces of paper. Each one's got a table on it. Now, each piece of paper represents a different biome, and each column of the table represents a faction that I think would go well in that biome, and things that I have ideas of what I could build. And then each row of the table is a different thing that I need to design. So let me just quickly take one for example. Now, I had a quick poll on my Facebook and said which biome would you like to see first. Huge amount of people said tundra, so I've done a bit of research on tundra, and the tundra is the zone, I'm going to talk about this in detail later, but the tundra is the zone between ice and tree. It's actually called the tree line. Trees can't grow in this zone because the soil is actually frozen. The top layer of it thaws every now and then, which has enough nutrients in for very small shrubs and little things to grow in it. But that's not important in this episode. I'll be talking about that when I actually start on the tundra thing. But what I'm going to be doing in this episode is going into the actual main map itself, creating that. It's probably going to take me quite a long time, but hey. So in tundra I have Nordic style. Now I'm going to be adding more styles to this, of course. I know a lot of people are kind of bored of my Nordic style, but you know, what can I do? I think that Nordic would work quite well in a tundra biome, and if you've got any ideas of what else could work in there, I guess Orc Goblin could fit in there quite nicely. I could come up with a totally new style based on the World of Warcraft Tunkers, if you've played that. I'll be coming up with something. Anyway, we don't need to worry about buildings yet. And then in between that, I've got Keep Tower, Barracks, Castle in my defensive, and then Religious, Leisure, and Entertainment, like brothels. I know people keep asking me for brothels. what else have we got, like concert halls, stuff like that, stuff for entertainment, bullfighting, arenas, that kind of stuff. Then we've got market, blacksmiths and lumber mills, and shops, water wheels, windmills and barns and farms, farmyards, stuff like that. That's all in the working section. And then we've got a small house, large house. I've decided to keep them quite simple deliberately because there's going to be lots of different house designs that I can't really categorise. And then there is a well, a wall and a port design, which I think are all quite important, but obviously some settlements won't need a port and some won't need walls. But yeah, so that's pretty much the plan. And I've got my little green and my little yellow highlighter, which I'm going to go ahead and highlight in yellow when I've started and green when I'm done. And then I'll be able to keep on track of everything, so it's nice and organised. I'll be able to come home and think, right, today I need to design a Nordic market in a tundra. Yeah, that'd be quite a lot of fun. So anyway, let me sit down a second. Ooh, take a breath. And look at my desktop. Isn't it lovely? So I've had some fiddling around with this. Basically, when I want to start a video, I will put the rendering files here. And then when they're rendered, I will put the two videos here, and this is my Upload Tonight box. And then, if I do another set of videos in the same day, I put it in this Upload Tomorrow Night box. And then all I need to do is move them along to the next box so I know what I'm uploading when. And over here is where I put all my raw files and stuff that isn't really important and trash. So that's quite nice. Just a little bit on my setup. Oh, I'm out of breath. I've been moving around my room, like, flailing my arms around, which you can't see. That's how I explain things, and just ignore me. Anyway, that's a world painter. So, I've got everything ready, except that's all I've done, so I haven't really got everything ready. So we're going to choose the dimensions for this world. Now this is going to be, basically I'm just creating a big flat world. I just want it to be a preset size, so that I know what space I'm working with. Now, the map I'm using as a kind of guideline is my recent the last map I uploaded for my 10,000 subscriber special, which is the one I built all my recent stuff on. And that was a 10x10 map. It was also pretty big, but I don't think it's big enough to house 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. I can count, trust me. 8 biomes in it. I just don't think those biomes are going to be big enough to have the full effect. So I'm going to go for something pretty big, something like 20x20, not 205. Each tile is 128, so that's 20 times 128, which I can't do maths. That'd be like 1,200 2560. Yeah, I think that's right. Holy crap, I think I just did a quick maths thing. Maths was definitely not my thing. Anyway, pretty big. Pretty freaking big. This might be too big, but it's easier to downsize than to upsize, so I'll just go with that for now. The height, 2,556. Oh yeah, of course it's 2,560, because everything's like multiples of 64, so yeah, that works. Yes, and I'm going to go for flat water level. Now, tough one, because of the new map height being so high, there's no real need for me to do the water level anything different than I normally would put it at, which is 64. So I think I might just put it on 64. It's got 54 here, let's put it on 64. And the level of the ground is going to be 65, for easiness sake. Grass material, yeah, grass biomes 1.2.3. I'm going to have custom biomes, but I'm not going to worry about that yet, but I'm just going to check that option. And then seed, I can just put as 4 for now, because obviously I'm going to be creating my own biomes anyway, and I know that 4 tends to be nothing. Right, so, hit create. Is this going to create quickly? Oh, looks like it is. Nice. Let's just turn on the biomes. Yeah, we can see there's a biome everywhere. I'll be worrying about that later. Just ignore that for now. Right, let's take a little zoom out, see how big this is. Okay, and let's put down... let's build a mountain. Where's the mountain button? Wow, I'm out of practice. There we go. Right, so this is the biggest mountain that I can build. Let's bear in mind this mountain is huge. Like, really huge. Like, monumentally huge. So this is a pretty big map. Okay, that mountain, I'm not even going to bother building that mountain all the way up. Right, basically, yes. Very nice. Awesome. Right, let me just check the water level quickly. Oh, don't zoom out that far. Yep, there's the water level, just below. Ideal. That's what I wanted. And, yes, I think it's pretty much ready for me to start. What I will do, though, is... No, I won't. Okay, no, I'll leave it as it is. That's okay. Now I'm going to go to File, Export World. Now, I don't think any of this actually matters at the moment, because I'm going to be re-exporting this world later. So what I'm going to do for now is I'm going to pop it in super flat mode. Oh wait, no, that does something bad. What does that do bad? Oh yeah, it means that biomes don't populate, so that's good. We want it in super flat mode. We don't want a chest of goodies, we do want creative mode. We want 1.2 anvil. Caverns, we're not going to worry about them yet. We're not also going to be worrying about resources. I'm not going to be worrying about that. Now, I'm sure there was another option I needed to change. That's it. Name. What the hell am I going to call this map? I have no idea. Wow. This is the kind of thing I should have thought about before. I'm going to call this map... I'm going to call this map Yarvek. For now. And the reason why is because I want to keep the Yarvek in my head, because when I've got enough time to do another series again, I will want to start up Tales of the Yarvek, but that won't be for a while, so don't like stop pestering me for it, because it's not going to happen soon. But I do want to keep that in my mind, because that is something I would like to do in the future. I'll change that later, so it's not a problem. Right, let's hit export. This is going to take a couple of hours, so I'll be back in a couple of hours. Alright guys, so I just loaded up the map and realised that I made a cock up, so this is how I'm going to do it now. So creative mode, super flat mode, allow my node, that's off, resources off, caverns off, but the thing I missed out is the border, so that was pretty dumb. So the border is going to be water at the level 64, so basically that's just going to make a pretty much endless ocean, and obviously I'm going to be making the cliffs of the ocean look pretty nice, but yeah, so let's go ahead and export this. This will take another few hours, so that was pretty much a cock up. Border size, I think. Oh, I see, that's how big the border goes. Oh, right, okay. That's actually an option I haven't used before. I just assumed that the water would carry on forever. Okay, well, two tiles, I think, is... Two tiles, that's 256. That's a big ocean. So I don't really need to worry about that. That's fine. Yeah. Okay, so I'm gonna click export again, and I will be back again in a couple of hours. Alright guys, so I'm just about to check the new the map, see if it's worked, but just before that I thought I'd point out this guy. I've just been looking around, and this will come back up later, but oh my god, it's not really American. This will come back up later. Oh my god. And this is a graph used by Minecraft to work out the biomes. So this is, if you remember that, if you've ever like looked at a texture pack, it's got a file in it which decides on the biome colouring, and it's a triangle. And the reason why it's a triangle is because of this. So down the bottom we have temperature. So this is the hottest temperature, and this is the coldest temperature. And here we have rainfall. So this is the least amount of rainfall, and this is the most amount of rainfall. So if we have hot temperatures and lots of rainfall, we have rainforest. If we have high temperatures and no rainfall, we have desert. If we have very low temperatures and not much rainfall, then we have tundra. And if we have very low temperatures and a bit of rainfall, then we have taiga. And it kind of works out into this curve. And this is, these are the biomes. So the ones I'm going to be starting up with is tundra. So what I'm actually thinking about doing is working around it in a more logical way, and actually working my way around across this this graph. But I'll be thinking about it a bit more later. Another thing I was thinking about is when I actually design the map, I might follow a design similar to this, not obviously creating a weirdly shaped build. But what I could do is take a slab of what would be a planet, like one continent of a planet, and the top of the continent is obviously near the ice cap, so we'd have lots of tundra, and that would be huge areas of just nothingness. And then as it came down through the layers, I would kind of replicate this kind of thing we've got going on, so that the further down to the equator you get, the more hot, and you get these kind of things. Yeah, so anyway, that's just an idea. I'm going to go check out the map. Okay, so welcome to the map. Now, for some reason, grass is generated. I think that's just because the material that the ground was made out of was actually set to generate grass, so that's nothing to do with biomes. So let me just put on fly 20, and also footsash set 1, and that'll set this as a waypoint. So let me just fly over here. Shouldn't take too long. In fact, it should take 10 seconds. I think it'd take 10 seconds. Anyway, if it was 20... Don't really know. Anyways, let's just go over here and see where the water is, see if it looks okay, and there we have it. So this is the water, and if we come out far enough on the water, we will come across a wall which leads down to grass down there, but we won't worry about that, because no one in their right mind would go that far into the sea. So here's our map. I'm actually going to go all the way to the one end, just to show you the scale. This is pretty big, and what the biomes! I said no biomes! That's fine, these biomes are all going to be edited anyway, so that's really not a problem that this has spawned here. But this is an example, if you missed my other video on the biomes, look at the sky. Ooh! So this is a really nice way that we're going to be able to use the biomes to our advantage. And we're in the swamp biome. Yep, nice and swampy. God, this place is huge. I think it's just rainforest here. God knows. And there's the other corner. See, so this map is freaking massive, and basically it's going to provide us with plenty of room. So what I'm going to do, oh god, a bit of lag there. What I'm going to do now is I'm just going to kind of map out some distances for me, because when you're on world edit, it's very hard to tell distance. So I'm just going to take this. I'm just going to go footsash brush sphere lapis brush sphere what would you call it instead of lapis? Alright, this is it. And let's pick what's something that would show up nice. Netherrack 10, and then mask air just so we don't fuck anything up. And I'll just go to one corner. Where's the corner? Oh, for God's sake, where are you? Any second now. There we go. Right, just plonk a big sphere there. Now what I'm going to do is put a sphere as far as I can see. So I'm going to come over this way as far as I can see. So now I know that that sphere is just on the edge of the horizon. And I'm going to do the same one further away. This is just on the edge. So, oops. Let me out. There we go. So theoretically, when I'm standing on this one here, no matter how far I look, I will never see that sphere over there. So this means that this would be a complete sight line. So I'm on far render distance, of course, at the moment, and that means that unless I turned on render distance far, this would be a really nice size free biome. So what I'm going to do is go back on World Painter, and I will see you guys there. Okay, so we're back on World Painter, and let's have a look at what we've done here. So this bit of map over here is the edge of the ocean where we looked at here. And over here is our little red dots. So these are going to give us an idea of just how big we need to make the place. So this is one entire sight line, and it's pretty huge. I don't really know how else to show it. Oops, no, not like that. Silly me. That won't work either. Okay, so there it is. The biggest box I can draw. That box there, and if I, you know, I can kind of put this on another place. That's a biome. That's a biome. That's a biome. That's a biome. And standing in there, you will not even be able to see the edges of this one. So that gives us an idea of how big the map needs to be. So I need to find out how big this brush I'm using is at the moment. Radius 190. Imagine 88, 200. About a radius of 200, I think, for the biomes. In fact, I'll go for 223. Yes, and I can make these obviously spherical. So they are going to be our biome boundaries. Now I need to kind of think about how I'm going to now do this. I'm going to open up a new map with the same size. I need to kind of position these biomes around and try and think about how I'm going to do it. So I think what I might do is go on Photoshop and have some kind of drawing around my graphics tablet and try and mark out these boundaries for myself, and then I will I'll come back to you guys and show you what I've done, and then we can try and translate it onto World Painter. It's going to be a bit of a task. It's actually worth mentioning how I'm going to do this, because this, like, the whole idea of putting it all in one map is logistically somewhat impossible, because for example, I'm going to want to put in archways. Now, I can't do archways. I can't build an archway now and then import it into World Painter and then re-export it from World Painter. That won't work. So that means that I need to have all my jungles and swamps and all the trees that I'm going to spawn in through World Painter. They need to be done after I've done all the terraforming using single player commands, which is the program I'll be using most of my terraforming for. Which is confusing as hell. So I need to think of a way of doing it. And I think the best way to do it is I'm going to create a basic map shape. I'm going to create the boundaries between these map shapes, roughly. They don't have to be very accurate. And then I'm going to copy that map and copy it eight times, one for each biome. And then I'm going to name each one accordingly. So one's going to be called Yavek Desert, Yavek Tundra, and then I'm going to, at the end, I'm going to copy and paste them all together and try and combine them, which is going to be a nightmare, like an absolute nightmare. So so let me kind of explain what I mean. Let me just go and paint a second. There we go. I'll just draw this with my mouse because I'm not bowels. Right, so say if I have a biome here. Okay. Oh, this is weird. Paint is updated. Ugh, that's horrible. Ugh, get it away. Get it to the fire. Right, so there's a biome. Now, for... Oh, fucking hell. This could be going better, can it? For argument's sake, let's make this a square, so I'm just going to erase this somehow. Bigger brush, please. Nope. Okay, is that as big as we go? Really? Are you serious? Fine. Whatever. No, I don't want to save. There we go, right. So this is a biome here. That is the sight line that we created earlier. Now, if I then have a mountain range coming... Where's the brushes? There we go. Mountain range coming... Why is it doing that? What the... What the... Okay, I think my graphics tablet's actually buggering this up, so let me bring up my graphics tablet. Right. There we go. That's a lot better. Right, so say we have mountains going up here. Now, I need these mountains to be thick enough so that I can copy and paste this entire biome and paste it next to the other biome, which is going to be, say, over here, without cocking it up too much and making sure these mountains still stay in check. For example, if... let me just zoom in a little bit. Oh, that apparently isn't the zoom button. Fine. There we go. Yeah, I really should have done some kind of rehearsal before I started this, but never mind. Stop it. Go away. There we go. Right, so we have a biome that is, say, shaped like this. Okay. And it's got a river going through like that. Let's just give it a nice little bit of blue colouring. Right, so we've got a river going through the middle. And let's say this is a jungle biome, so let's have lots of nice jungle. Look at all that jungle, isn't it lovely? And then over here, we have another biome. Where's brushes? Oh, wait, no, black. There we go. And this one is going to be, what will go next to jungle? Let's say a forest. This is just a forest biome, so it's just got some normal, nice trees in it. And it's about that shape. And we've got, again, a river coming along here. And some lovely trees, but these are going to be light trees because these are forest trees. Lovely. So we need a way of separating these two biomes. Now, the obvious way is with the river. And the river would have to go down here. And that means that these biomes would have to come up. But if I create these two biomes separately, then I need to create a box. And this is going to be the bit that's going to be really hard. I need to create a box that I can copy with World Painter that intersects like this, but obviously square, intersects this whole river without going over the edges like this. Does that make any sense at all? I really don't know. I'm not sure if I'm explaining it very well. Let me just think about this. I don't even know what I'm doing myself, and then trying to explain it. Basically, it's going to be a nightmare. It's going to be really hard. So I need to think hard about the order that I'm going to do biomes in, and I'm going to do them all in separate maps to make my life easier. And then I guess I'll just have to worry about how they're all going to fit together later on. It might just take a huge amount of editing with MC Edit or something like that. In fact, MC Edit would probably be the best thing to use, because then I can select new regions quite simply. Yeah, in fact, that will probably be the way to use it. Yeah. So basically, I want to try and make my biomes as square as possible, and if they're not square, then they need to fit inside a square within the margins of the in-between borders between the two biomes. My god, this is annoying. Right, anyway, basically, let's get back to map design, and I will